Did you know Lane Cove Plaza was the first pedestrian mall in New South Wales created by closing a main road? Officially opened in 1977, the plaza was regarded as a bit radical by then Mayor Alderman Bill Henningham. Lane Cove's pioneering move in the 70s has been followed by many others. Just look at Martin Place in the heart of the Sydney CBD. Today, Lane Cove Plaza is home to village shopping, civic occasions, outdoor dining and family-friendly socialising, with the Bandstand providing the focal point for numerous open-air events and performances. The Bandstand arose from an approach from the eminent landscape artist and local resident Lloyd Rees in 1983 to provide a focal point for the plaza. Council engaged its long-time landscape architect, Harry Howard, to develop the Bandstand, and in honour of Lloyd Rees, was named the Lloyd Rees Bandstand. There have been modifications to the Bandstand over the years. The most significant was in 1996, when it was relocated to where it stands today. In 2007, the now popular shade sails were also added to its surrounds. Council during 2010 is consulting with the community to consider three options for the upgrade of the Lloyd Rees Bandstand and Lane Cove Plaza. Let's take a look first at the Bandstand concepts. Option 1, Richard Goodwin Bandstand Concept. Option 1 was prepared by Richard Goodwin, who also prepared Council's recent public art strategy and was a former student of Harry Howard. Features of Option 1 include lowering the Bandstand performance platform to be level with the existing grassed area, removing the side ramps, reducing the height of the side walls, retaining the existing shade structure, raising the stainless steel columns and canopy by 500 millimetres to their original height. The grassed area will remain unchanged. Option 2, Super and Buchanan Bandstand Concept. Option 2 was prepared by Barbara Buchanan and the late John Supran, who were both involved in the original works with Harry Howard for the Lloyd Rees Bandstand. Features of Option 2 include raising the Bandstand performance platform by one step compared to the existing height, relocating the side ramp to the Market Square side of the plaza, the installation of new stainless steel handrails to the back and sides, removing the sidewalls and replacing them with steps, retaining walls removed from grassed area and sloped to meet surrounding levels, reducing the shade structure from 3 to 2 sails. Option 3, Council Staff Bandstand Concept. Option 3 was prepared by Council's in-house landscape architects. Features of Option 3 include retaining the existing height of the Bandstand performance platform, relocation of side ramp to rear of the Bandstand, reconfiguration of the performance platform and steps, removing the sidewalls and replacing them with steps, modified and extended grassed area with integrated seating, new, redesigned and raised shade canopy with open views to the Bandstand, shade structure poles to incorporate festival banners, artwork and lighting. Lane Cove Plaza Concepts. Plans have also been prepared for the upgrade of the remaining components of Lane Cove Plaza. There are also three options for consideration for the plaza, with two of them prepared by Council's consultants for the Public Domain Master Plan, Spackman Mossop Michaels, and the third prepared by Council's in-house landscape architects. An aerial view of Lane Cove Plaza reveals there are three areas. 1. Entrance point from Longaville Road. 2. Central area with entrance from Birdwood Lane, comprising of the raised deck eating area the bandstand and grassed area. 3. Entrance point from Burns Bay Road. Option 1. Spackman Mossop Michaels Concept 1. Features include retention of existing treatment of pedestrian crossing surrounds, the reduction in the size of garden beds at Longueville Road, redesigning of existing planter box and surrounds to integrate seating at the Longueville Road end of the plaza, soft floor play area with shade cell to replace timber deck under the tree canopy, new shade structure between Michelle's Patisserie and Aristocrat Coffee Lounge with integrated seating. Bandstand and grassed area to be determined based on consultation on bandstand concepts. Retaining walls around garden beds removed to assist with drainage. Provision made for a future water feature. Existing pavers to be reused in feature areas by turning them on the side. Option 2. Spackman Mossop Michaels Concept 2. Option 2 is identical to Option 1, except it provides for the relocation of the bandstand to Longueville Road, end of the plaza. Should this option be chosen, the bandstand concepts will need to be modified. Option 3. Council Staffed Concept. Option 3 includes the reconfiguration of the Longueville Road crossing garden beds, with removal of the garden beds to make provision for a possible water feature. Timber deck area under existing trees, extended and cantilevered with underlighting. Reconfiguration of retaining walls and garden beds to provide an entrance threshold and integrated seating. New feature paving to be utilised at entry points and on bandstand and grassed area surrounds. If you would like to make sure you have your say, visit www.lanecove.nsw.gov.au/plaza. Once we obtain the community's view on the most favoured options for the Lloyd Rees Bandstand and Lane Cove Plaza, Council will determine the preferred option for the upgrade of the plaza.